Hey, what's up, fellas? How we doing? Man, Antonelli here. Today, checking out some more World Series footage. Looking at Justin Turner again. We've put up a couple videos of Justin Turner, so go back and check out the other ones if you've not seen them already. Today, we're talking about footwork as a third baseman, dictating the hop. We've talked about drop stepping, and so now we're going to talk today about when you see the ball chop like that, use your feet. And typically, again, when you see the ball chopped, boom, ball hits right in front of the plate. You see some air under the ball. Typically, as a third baseman, you want to come get that ball, right? Try to get it before it bounces again. Worst comes to worst, here, he's trying to get this on the short hop, and he actually probably could have made it a little bit easier on himself if he was able to get there a step sooner. Again, you're not always able to do that. But just remember, as a third baseman or as any fielder, you're trying to dictate the hop, right? So you want to get the short hop, which is the ball that bounces right before your glove. And that's, I classify this as a short hop. Even though, again, ball's bouncing right there, he probably could have been a smidge closer. But you're trying to get the short hop or the long hop. The long hop would be one where ball's bouncing out here and you're fielding it on the up bounce or the longer bounce. You want to stay away from the in-between hop, the one that kind of eats you up. So in-between hop would be, probably if it bounced right about there and comes up, and now he has, he's probably going to wear it off the chest or it's going to scoot by him. And you do that, you dictate the top by you hop by using your feet. So again, he charges the ball here. You can see he's got active feet, right? Ball's chopped, boom, he's coming in to field the ball. He's attacking it, trying to get it off the short hop. He's not sitting back and waiting for it. Now, if you've seen our other videos, sometimes the best option is to go back, right? Take a drop step, create some more distance so you can get the long hop. But you're either going to go forward or back, and the important thing is to use your feet. Typically, for third baseman, when you see them get stuck, I call it stuck in the mud, their feet just get stagnant, that's when you're going to get in between hops because you're not, now you're at the mercy of the ball and how the ball is going to bounce, and you're not dictating anything. You need to be in control, and you're moving your feet. I step up, I drop step, I slow down, I speed up, right? You do that to be able to get the hop you want. It's much easier to field short hops and long hops. In between hops are tough. Those are typically going to be errors. Or the balls you miss and then you say, ah, oh, man, took a bad hop, right? Didn't really take a bad hop. You just didn't get the good hop. So, hopefully this makes sense to you guys. Let me know if you guys have any questions in the comment section below. Subscribe to the channel if you've not done so already. Share the video with all your friends. Give it a thumbs up. I'd appreciate that. Check out our Instagram, Antonelli Baseball, Twitter feed, @Antonelli9. We're posting videos all the time for you guys. Check out the description box below. I got a bunch of links and stuff for you guys. And that's all I got. Thanks again. Good luck to you. And we'll talk to you later.